Let's start with the easy way for multiplying two numbers. Here I have 12 and 13, which are of course two-digit numbers. First, draw one single line representing 1 in 12, and then on the other side draw two lines representing 2 in 12. Do the same on the other side by keeping in mind the numbers. When we consider the first row, we have only one dot. Then in the middle row, we have 2 and 3 dots, which has to be added to 5. On the last row, we have 6 dots, which totally makes up 156. To cross-check, let's multiply with our normal multiplication method. Great! When we finally look at both the method's answers, we get to know that both the answers are same. The easiest way to add and subtract fractions is here. You don't have to take LCM at all. Instead, cross multiply, that is multiply 8 in the denominator with 2 and 3 with 6. And also don't forget to multiply 3 and 8. We get the answer as 17 by 12. Now, let's apply the same formula for subtracting two fractions. The final answer is 23 by 9. Most of us find trigonometry difficult, but here's the easiest hack to find out the value of standard angles. We know that the standard angles are 0, 30, 45, 60 and 90 degrees. First of all, write up the numbers from 0 to 4 so as to fill up the angles, and then divide the numbers from 4. After that, just write down the trigonometrical ratios. Since sine and a zero is zero itself, to find out the other values of sine, divide the numbers if possible and find the square roots. The reverse of sine values are cos values. We get tan values by dividing sine by cos. The reverse of tan is cot. The fraction reverse of cos is secant and reverse of secant is cosecant. We are done! Hope you like this video. Make sure you subscribe, like and share, and also comment whether this video was useful for you or not. Thank you!